Hi everyone, I'm Aaron Lewis, content producer at Edmunds, the car shopping destination. We've been here all week, many of us at the staff at Edmunds, checking out all of the technology that's on display here at CES. And I wanted to start with you, Ron. Ron Montoya, you are our senior consumer advice editor. You've been looking at a lot of stuff that's coming in the near term, especially autonomous technology in cars. Tell us a little bit about what you're seeing about autonomy.
Yeah, well, CES seems to be the annual progress indicator for where we are on autonomous technology. And it seems like every year we get a little bit closer. And this year seems to be a nice sweet spot in which computing technology is getting to the point where it's able to be shrunk down and put into a vehicle that can learn and adapt to its surroundings. And you have a company like Audi saying that within a couple of years, by 2020, they will have a level four self-driving car. And that means level four means that in many situations the car can drive itself, and only in some situations does the actual driver have to intervene and drive the vehicle. So Audi, you have, they're partnering with Nvidia to have these high powered computer chips, so they're at the front lines of it, whereas Toyota, who was speaking earlier, they feel like it's a little bit more difficult and they need a little bit more time to kind of sort this out.
So it sounds like a little bit of a mixed bag with autonomy, but Mark, you've been looking at stuff that's been coming far off in the future now. There's especially Toyota has some really interesting stuff that really is coming up far down the line. What was that you saw here?
Yeah,
CES?
The Toyota Concept I is just bonkers. I mean, it's so forward looking. I mean, it looked like it was out of Minority Report. It's the AI is the key on the interior, actually. It's supposed to learn you and give you what you want. Ron and I were in the simulator, and at one point we're on a highway run, and all of a sudden it went into autonomous mode. The seat started reclining, and we started getting this lower back massage. It was fantastic. And I had this big grin on my face, but it was tracking my facial expressions, and it knew when I was happy. And after time, it learns what makes you happy, and if it sees that you're not happy, it will try to do whatever it can to make you happy. It's weird. It's using technology to give it personality, almost.
And that human-machine interface is definitely a theme here at CES. Greg Shaffer, you're one of our senior director of products here at Edmunds. You do a lot of work in AI, voice controls, Alexa. How is that all folding into the car ownership, car shopping experience?
Yeah, one thing you can see a lot of here at CES this year is Alexa everywhere, Amazon's voice technology. It was debuted a number of years ago in their Echo products. And they really have a big ground hold on developers integrating with it. A lot of manufacturers out there are integrating, integrating with the Echo devices, so you can unlock your car, start your car, turn your lights on from your kitchen just by talking to your Alexa, Echo, or Dot device. But also, they're integrating that voice technology inside the car, so you could be sitting in your car and say, it's a rainy day and you realize you need some new windshield wipers, Volkswagen can actually introduce this. You can actually say, Alexa, order me some new windshield wipers. It knows the exact size you need for the exact car. It's hooked up to your Amazon Prime account, and they show up in your doorstep a couple days later. So it's those kind of full end-to-end connections of technology that we're seeing between Amazon and manufacturers. Some manufacturers are using the Google technology, Google Home or Google Assistant. I see Hyundai chose to use them. But it's really, really fascinating how far AI has gone with the voice. And not just voice, the image recognition, the image detection technologies of artificial intelligence have really gone a long way. Nvidia, which you don't really hear in automotive a lot, really is one of those behind-the-scenes players that has a lot of technologies that enable these autonomous vehicles behind the scenes.
Yeah, and speaking of NVIDIA, Brock Stearn, he's our Director of Immersive Technology at Edmunds, which is kind of a fancy way of saying VR. I know that you're playing around. You're the guy around the office with the VR glasses, the VR cameras, 360 cameras. You mentioned earlier today to me, I thought it was interesting how Nvidia is using VR to help build their products and improve this whole driving experience. Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, Nvidia has been a big player in gaming for ages, a big player in VR, and you know they've been in automotive. They power the center console of the Tesla, things like that. But with the drive, the Nvidia drive that they announced, they're using technology from VR like eye tracking to pull it into automotive. And eye tracking isn't just where you're looking, but the depth that you're looking. So it starts to open up possibilities that you could actually have a heads-up display in the windshield that adjusts for the distance you're looking. If you're looking at the car immediately in front of you, or if you're looking at a sign far away. And so you're never really losing that information when you're driving a car, which is amazing. Mm-hmm. And can be used now, even though they're advertising it as fully autonomous driving. But all VR related, I mean, CES last year had a lot of VR, this year has way more. Almost every car manufacturer has something VR related, whether a VR test drive, 360 video, or VR sit in our car, change some options. There's a lot of that at the LA Auto Show, and they're basically bringing that here and then adding a little bit more to it. The LA Auto Show wasn't too far away. And then Ford took an interesting approach. They partnered with Forza to put the Ford GT in there. And so their big experience is driving in a driving simulator, that Ford GT, inside the Forza game. It's a little cheesy because it's the game that's already out, but it's just the Ford GT you get to drive, and it's in a driving simulator, so it's better than most people have at home. But all in all, VR is big, and every auto company is using it.
It's really an exciting time. A lot of technology out there that's really improving both the car shopping, the car development, product experience. So a lot to be excited about here in Las Vegas for CES. That's it for now. We'll keep at it. I'm Aaron Lewis for Edmunds. Take care.